Hello, children. Hope finds you in the best of your health and safety. Today, we are going to learn about punctuation marks. Now, let's read this sentence. Let's eat grandma. That means we are going to eat grandma. No, we mean let's eat grandma. So, this means punctuations are helping you to give the meaning and save lives. Now, let's learn about the importance of punctuation marks. They show reader where sentence starts and ends. It also helps to bring the right kind of expression into writing. It changes the tone of voice to show emphasis. It creates clarity in the sentence. So, because of all these reasons, it's very important to use the punctuation marks correctly. So, we can say that punctuation marks are used in writing to separate sentences and their elements to clarify the meaning. Here are a few examples of punctuation mark: apostrophe, colon, comma, exclamation mark, period, question mark, full stop, etc. Now, let's learn about each one of them turn by turn. Among all, the first and commonly used is full stop. A full stop is used at the end of a sentence. Every time you see a full stop, that means that you have to stop. I must stop at the end of sentence. So it's used at the end of the sentence. Then next is question mark, which is used when you are asking a question. It is used at the end of a sentence which is interrogative or which is asking you a question. For example, how old are you? So here we have asked a question, so we have put a question mark at the end of it. The next among all the punctuation marks is exclamation mark, which is used with the exclamatory sentences, and it ends a sentence that shows strong emotion. Like here, we are saying, you are a dog, you are showing your expressions. So here we have used the sign of exclamation at the end of it because we were expressing our feelings in this sentence. So we can say that an exclamation mark is used at the end of an exciting sentence where your feelings are being expressed. The next among these is apostrophe. Apostrophe is used to show possession. General rule is that the possessive of a singular noun is formed by adding an apostrophe and s whether the singular noun ends in s or not. Now let's look at this example. The boy's pencil. So here we are showing the possession that the pencil belongs to the boy, and we have put an apostrophe s with boy. Boy's pencil. Another use of apostrophe is to show contractions of the word. We can use contractions to shorten a word by removing one letter or more letter and substituting an apostrophe in the same spot. Like here, am, can't, which means cannot. So here, the apostrophe mark is there to show the missing letters. I hope this is clear to everyone. Now next is quotation marks. These are used to show when someone is speaking. They go before and after someone's words. So when you are quoting the exact words of the person, then we put the quotation marks. Like, did you like this book? Ask the teacher. So the exact words of the teacher are put within the quotation marks. Similarly, Tim replied, it was the best book ever. So the words, the exact words spoken by Tim are put within the quotation marks. I hope this must be clear to all of you. Now let's switch to learn how to use commas. We use commas to separate three or more words in a series. Like Jen has a pencil, a book, and a crayon. So we have used commas to separate these words. Pencil separated from book and then crayon. So the basic rule of using a comma is to separate three or more words written in a series. I like to eat apples, grapes, and bananas for snack. So we have separated all the names of the fruits by using commas. I hope you all must have enjoyed learning the punctuation marks. So now let's recapitulate via an activity. Here, Few concepts and the basics of each punctuation mark are given, and they want you to identify them. Like the first one is saying, I think we should take a break for a second. So what is this punctuation mark called, which is used when you want to take a small break? Then the next one is, I think we should stop altogether. What do you use when you have to stop? The next one says, I agree. That means you are expressing your feelings. So which punctuation mark helps you to end an exclamatory sentence? And the last but not the least is the one which wants you to tell that if he is asking a question, what are you guys talking about? So which punctuation mark will be used to end that proper interrogative sentence? I hope you all will enjoy doing this activity on an A4 size sheet. Do this activity on an A4 size sheet and paste it in your English notebook. Thank you.